Sete putras atrás rupam, rupam tasya gajam vipuri maturim koshtvatim radha kunda Paharikamarvasam Praptoyasya Pratita Kripaya Sri Guru Tam Natosmi Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namah Ananda Lila Maya Vikrahaya Hema Bhakti Vyachave Sundaraya Tasmai Mahaprema Rasapradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namah Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Bhaktivedanta Sasang Dandavat Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands of times at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev. Asmatiya Paramaradatama Guru Pada Padma, Nitya Lila Pravisht Om Vishnu Pada Shtotara Sattva Sri, Rupa Anuga Charyavarya Sri Sri Lad, Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Secondly, I offer my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Param Gurudev and to Srila Prabhupada and to all of our Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. And finally, I offer my pranam to all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, Panchakaurudurubis, Kripas and Dubeyavaja, Vatitanam Bhavanenyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namah.
Jila Gurudev! Yeah.
By the causes mercy of Sri Gurand Gauranga, we have been hearing from Sri Bhajan Rahasya of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. in the first chapter, the seven excellent results of Naam Sankirtan were described to create faith in the hearts of the devotees. And this first chapter is called Nishanta Bhajan. Nishanta means Nisha, night, Anta, the end of night. So, for the conditioned souls who are approaching the lotus feet of the spiritual master, they're beginning their spiritual life, then this is Nishanta, the end of the night of thousands and millions, endless lifetimes in the darkness of Maya. And now that is coming to an end, and some light of transcendental knowledge is approaching them. So, it is Nishanta Bhajan for the beginning devotees. Krishna in Gita said, Yani Shasav Bhutani, that which is night for all living entities is day for the sadhu. And what is night for the sadhu is day for the living entities. That means that the living entities are running around here and there, thinking I'm doing so much. I'm creating an empire. One house, two houses, one car, two cars, three cars. I'm building my business and everything. They think they are awake. And they look at the sadhu, sitting chanting, Hey Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Ram. This useless fellow is doing nothing. What contribution is he making to the world? He's sleeping. So the materialist thinks like this. But the sadhu, his soul is awake to the reality of Sri Krishna. And he sees that soul who is busy doing karma and sees actually his soul is asleep. And only by the influence of Maya he thinks that he is very busy and creative. But he's doing nothing. Only the reactions of past life karma, this is, he gets that result. People become very proud. I have done this. No. Many people work hard, but they're still poor. And other persons, they don't work so hard, but they become very rich. Why? Because everyone is only tasting the fruit of their past life's karma. So, this material existence is like night time. And when a soul comes into the association of devotees and begins his devotional life, some faith comes. It is Nishanta, the end of that night of material existence. Now remember that each chapter is also, each yugal nav is also there to reveal to the devotees in the stage of bhav, the jatarati sadakas, the astakali lila, the 24 hours eternal pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So they also have Nishanta Bhajan. That is the end of the night, Radha Krishna, they woke up in a beautiful kunj and then very quickly they had to return to their homes. Then we came to the second chapter, that is the Pratakalin Bhajan, morning time, 6 o'clock till 8:24. So in the second chapter, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur discussed the stages of Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya and Anatta Nivritti. He discussed about the power, the unlimited Shakti in the Holy Name. He presented verses which are on the subject of Sambandha Gyan and Abhideya and Prayojan. Because by hearing, one must hear to remove the Tattva Brahm, Swarup Brahm, philosophical misconceptions. Otherwise, one cannot go through Anatta Nivritti and attain Nishta steadiness. We heard in this chapter how the devotee chants very beautiful names of Krishna, which are full of sweetness. Agadamana Yashoda Nandano Nandasuno Kamalanayana Gopi Chandra Vrindavanendra. And gradually, practicing according to the second chapter, he comes to the stage of Nishtha, the third chapter. That is the practice of the Ajatarati Sadhak. But in the end of the second chapter, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives another verse, originally from the Radha Krishna Astakali Lila Mangala Smarana Stotram of Rupa Goswami, and it has been quoted in Govinda Lilamrita of Srila Krishna Kaviraj Goswami as well. It is just a sutra describing that Prata Lila. Radham Snata Vibhushitam Brajapayita Huttam Sakibi Pragi. What happens in the morning? Radhika is sleeping in her bedchamber in Yavat, the house of her in-laws. For the gopis, the jungle, the forest is the home. But in the home is like a jungle. Because the home is full of wild animals, like a Jyotila and Kutila and Abhimanyu. So now Radhika has to return there, and she is still sleeping. The sun is already starting to rise. At that time, the maid servants of Radhika are very busy, already, before Radhika is awake. They go to the bathing room of Radhika. Pranalim kilala bahubira bisansalya madure mudasamma jaswa vivritta kachabrinda priyataya kathabhaya gharam varam parimalam dupanivai vidasyete devi pratidinamaho vasatamaham. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is crying and saying, when will that day come? When Radhika is still resting, I will be alert and awake to go to her bathing room and clean there, taking so many pots of fragrant water and pouring them everywhere, wiping the channels, the pranali. There are drains where the water will go out. And then, seeing that there are still some spots of water and smears here and there, I will untie my braid and with tears, clean the drains of Radhika's bathing room with my hair. How dear the maidservants of Radhika are to Radhika, and how dear Radhika is to her maidservants. After cleaning everything and then lighting incense, so the place is full of very fragrant smoke, now it's ready to receive Radhika for her morning bathing. So then quickly, those maidservants who are cleaning, they wash themselves and get changed and go to Radhika's room. But when they get to Radhika's room, it's clear that she's not up yet, because Lalita, Vishakha and others are still standing outside. And Mukara, Radharani's maternal grandmother, she has come there. She has so much love for Radhika, even more love than Radhika's own mother, Kirtita. Kirtita does not come every day. But Mukara, the grandmother, every morning she comes to see her beloved Naptri, granddaughter. Jyotila, being the mother-in-law, is hesitant. She will not go at once into the room. But Radhika used to play on the lap of Mukara when she was a little baby, running around naked. So Mukura has so much intimacy with Radhika. She does not feel any hesitation. So without any introduction or without knocking, then Mukura just comes in. Oh, my dear granddaughter, why are you still sleeping? The sun is rising, everyone is awake. And she comes in, and there she sees Radhika asleep, wrapped in Krishna's Pitambara. Lalita Vishakha Atasaki say enter. Mukura is astonished. I think that just yesterday I saw this very cloth somewhere on the son of Nanda Maharaj. What is this? And just as he was saying this, then Vishakha said, you are Jarati? You're an old lady? Your mind is not steady anymore and your eyesight is not so good. Look at the window. The golden rays of the sun are shining through and making Radhika's blue cloth seem golden. And then as Mukura looked towards the window, then Rati Manjari quickly took the yellow cloth and put a blue cloth there. Then Mukura, she turned around and looked. Oh, it's blue, yes. I must be getting old. The Sakhi said, oh, what were you saying? Nothing. I wasn't saying anything. And she quickly left. All the Sakhis of Radhika are laughing. I'm very satisfied. Just then, in the morning time, one gopi from another group, a group leader, Shamala, she comes to visit Radhika in the morning. You know, there are different groups of gopis, four main groups, types. First, Swapaksh, Radharani's own group. Then, on the other end of the spectrum, Vipaksh, the anti-party, Chandravali, and those Sakhis whose mood is very much different to Radhika's. Radhika has Madhu Sneha, affection like honey. They have Grita Sneha, affection like ghee. So, ghee is good, honey is good, but when you mix them together, it becomes poisonous in equal varieties. Those of you who know Ayurveda already know this. So, the Madhu Sneha group and the Grita Sneha group, they don't mix well. So, there's the Vipaksh. Then there is the Tatastha Paksh. They are the groups which are friendly to the anti-party and neutral to Radhika's group. And then there are the Surit Paksh. Surit Paksh, they are friends. They are well-wishers. They want to help Radhika and her group also. Whereas the Tatastha group, they are neutral. They'll not do anything to help, but not do anything against also. And the Vipaksh, the anti-party, they're always thinking how to sabotage the other group. Give false information. So, Shamala, she has some Madhu Sneha. In the larger proportion, and Krishna say in a smaller proportion. So, in the morning time, it's customary to go and take bath in a holy lake. But Shamala has come in the morning because she wants to take bath. In Radhika is like a lake, full of the water of rasa. And she wants to come there to take a bath in Harikatha. That means she's going there to ask Radhika, what happened last night? Tell me all the latest news. So very excited, she comes there to see Radhika. And when Radhika sees her, then she's overjoyed and embraces her. Today may be my most fortunate day because I've seen you. You are so auspicious. Why? Because just at this moment I was thinking of you and you appeared. So you are a very auspicious person. And seeing an auspicious person like you, then the fruit may come on the tree of my desires. You see, in my heart I had a desire and it grew and grew into a large tree with so many leaves. But until this day, not one fruit has come on that tree of my desire. Shyamala said, oh, what are you saying? I think that you have been relishing so much fruit from this tree. Because, especially when mango, the first mangoes come. So the first bite of the mango, there's some bitterness there. That's why mango is sweet after it's been pecked by the parrot. And from that bitterness, some sore can come on the lip. So seeing that there's some marks on the lips of Radhika, said, I can see that you've been relishing some fruits. You've been eating so much, even the juice is in your eyes. Because the tumble that Krishna was chewing makes a red color, and there was some smear on the eyelids of Radhika. So she said, I think that you have been relishing so much fruit. Don't tell me that no fruit has come on the tree of your desire. Radharani said, I will not argue with you. But when it's a Amavasya, a dark moon night, and the sky is full of dark rain clouds, and it's raining, it's very dark, but suddenly, if there's a flash of lightning, then after the flash of lightning, it seems even darker. So that is my position. It may be that I saw Krishna just for a moment, but now it feels the separation is even more intense, and it feels that I never met with him. I did not taste any juice of that fruit at all. Shyamal said, no. It is not like that. I know that you are very thirsty to relish the sweetness of Krishna. So you are like a person who was thirsty. They did not drink for many days. And finally someone gave them some water. And they went, boop, and drank it all very quickly. Then that friend said, oh, how did the water taste? He said, oh, I didn't taste it. Because the person was so eager to drink that they didn't taste. So you are like that. Oh, your anurag, your eagerness to relish Krishna is so intense that you feel that you have not relished anything. Usually, in the field of knowledge, there are two things. Theoretical knowledge and then realized knowledge. So, usually, theoretical knowledge comes first and then the realized knowledge comes. But you are the other way around. Shyamala said to Radhika, you went to one Shyama Guru. And from that Guru, you received realized knowledge, but you did not receive the theoretical knowledge. If I ask you, you cannot say anything. So for you it was backwards. Radharani was laughing. She said, oh Shyamala, what can I say? Shyamala said, you should go back to that Shyama Guru and so you can also get the theoretical knowledge. And then you can tell me. Radharani said, oh, I am foolish. I am inexperienced. I am not mature. I am not qualified to understand this subject. I think, Shyamala, that it's better that you go to that guru. And you can get the theoretical knowledge and the realized knowledge. And then you can come back and you can tell me about it. In this way, with so many words, with hidden meanings, Shyamala is taking bath in Harikatha and inspiring Radhika to remember her pastimes with Sri Krishna. Being very pleased then, Shyamala went away. And then Radhika came to her bathing place and she was bathed and decorated by her sakis. And then, message came. Madhya Yashoda sent one messenger, please come and cook in the kitchen. Because there are many dangers in Braja. Many demons come. And I am very worried about my son. But I know that the daughter of Vrishabhanu Maharaj, once she served Durvasa Rishi, and Durvasa Rishi gave a blessing that anything that you cook, anything touched by your hands will be more delicious than amrita, nectar. And if someone will taste your cooking, then they'll never be defeated and they'll have long and successful life. So I'm very worried about my son. So the daughter of Vrishabhanu Maharaj, please tell her to come and cook in my kitchen. Everyone thinks that Krishna has killed so many demons, but we think it was not Krishna, it was because of the power of Radhika's cooking. So then, Radhika and her sakhi set out from Gyavat, and they go to Nandagaon. As they're approaching Nandagaon, Madhya Yashoda comes out from the palace of Nanda Maharaj to greet them. And Radhika comes with so many sakis and maidservants and they give pranam one by one to Madhya Yashoda and Madhya Yashoda embraces them. Alinganena sirasa parichumbanena snehavalokana bharena jakanjanakshi gosteshaya navavidum ivalalyamanam tam prakshakim ridhi mahutsamamata nisye. When will I be there and see that scene? When Madhya Yashoda sees Radhika, Radhika bows down and as she stands up, Madhya Yashoda alinganin embraces her. Sirasa parichumbanena and kisses her on the head. Here, 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 here. And then, when she's kissing, then she's too close. So then she holds her at a distance like that. And with eyes full of affection, she looks at Radhika and then again embraces her. Gosteshaya navavidum ivalalyamanam. Krishna is not married. But if he were married and Madhya Yashoda had a navavadu, a new daughter-in-law, then Madhya Yashoda would embrace that daughter-in-law like this. So because Madhya Yashoda is just smothering Radhika with affection as if she were her navavadu, her new daughter-in-law, this is getting a little bit too close to the truth. As Madhya Yashoda is embracing her and caressing her, Radhika is Kanjanakshi. Her eyes are looking here and there like whack table, very nervously looking around. What are others thinking? Then Radhika goes to the kitchen. And one by one, everyone, all the sakis are bowing down to Madhya Yashoda and she's giving them so much love and affection. Tom Prakshakim. And he say, when will I see such a festival for the heart? Then Radhika is in the kitchen. There are 100 stoves there. The stoves are very hot. But Radhika feels they're cool. Because before, she was feeling the heat of separation from Krishna. But now she has a chance to serve him. That heat of separation has gone down and the heat of the fires is cooling. After milking the cows and taking bath, Krishna comes for his breakfast and sits down with Madhu Mangal Subal and others. And Mother Rohini is directing the servants of the house to come and bring the various preparations. Radhika from a balcony with a Jalarandra, with a lattice window, she's looking and seeing how Krishna is tasting the preparations that she's making. All her love has gone into that preparation. And when Krishna tastes it, then Lokottara Padatanam Prabhava Kopyanagalaha, we're discussing. The supernatural substances have such inconceivable power. Krishna begins to experience the feelings that Radhika has when she was cooking for him. So he's not exactly tasting the preparation, but he's tasting Radhika's prem. Madhya Yashoda comes, oh, why are you here? Come and help serve. No. Yes, here, take this tray of puris. And she gives Radhika a tray of puris. Then Radhika comes with the tray, and she comes to the line, and she's giving, and as she gets closer and closer to Krishna, the sattvic bhavas, the ecstatic mood is becoming stronger and stronger, her hands are trembling, and as she gets close to Krishna, she drops the whole tray and they go everywhere. Very embarrassed, she runs away. So there are many pastimes in this Prata Lila. So for those who have become Jatarati, Bhavas appeared in their heart, they are absorbed at that time in the morning in realizing all this Lila. It will come, it will start to come. Just an abhas of that will start to appear in the higher stage of Asakti. And then really one can be absorbed in this internal service in the stage of Bhava. So now we're coming to the third chapter. Tritiya Yam Sadhan Purvan Kaliya Bhajan. So this corresponds to the stage of Nishtha, and it has been described by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the third verse of Shikshastaka. Trinadapi suni chena tarorapi saishtuna amanina manadena kirtanya sadari. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself explained his own verse. Ye rupe loilanam prema upajoy taralakshan slok suno swarup ramarai. Mahaprabhu was in the Gambhira with his two intimate associates, Sorup Damodar and Rai Ramananda. He said, oh, Sorup Damodar, Rai Ramananda, now listen, the way in which one should chant the holy name, by which prem upajai, love for Krishna awakens in the heart. Listen to the symptoms, tara lakshana sloka. Uttamaya apanaki manitunadam, dui prakare sahushnata kare brikshasam. Even though the devotee is uttam, he is very high class, but he considers himself more worthless than blade of grass, than a dry straw. Dui prakare, and in two ways, he tolerates everything like a tree. Brikshayena kotileya kichuna balai. Sukaya milaya kare pani na bagai. If someone comes to a tree with an axe to cut, he's attacking the tree to cut it. But the tree never complains. If we want to attain Krishna Prem, then you'll have to become like this. A problem comes in your life, someone makes a problem. Don't say it. Depend on Krishna. Sukhe malaya kari pani na magai. And if the tree is drying up because there was no rain for a long time and someone walks past carrying water, the tree will not say, hey, look, you give me some of that water. It's not begging. So not begging from anyone, anything. Just depend on Krishna. Whatever is needed, Krishna will send. Ye ye magai tare de apandhan. And at the same time, if someone will come to the tree, can I have your fruits? Your flowers? Your branches? Your old trunk? Yes, the tree. Take whatever you want. So the devotee has to have that liberal spirit, generosity, to be concerned about the welfare of others and to sacrifice for their benefit. Kama vrishti sahi ane kare rakshan. And when the sun is shining with the blazing heat and the tree is being burned by the sun, but at the same time the tree is giving shade to others. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining, these are the qualities. This is the way we must live. And if one has such a mood, then when he chants the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Kirtaniya Sadhari continuously. Then, this Anarpita Acharim Chirat Kruneya Bhakti Naha Kalo Sumarpaita Munnata Ujvala Rasam So Bhakti Sriyam. This rare love that was never given before in this day of Lord Brahma, that will rise up in the devotee's heart. Uttamaya Vaisnava Ave Niratman Jive Samanjive Jani Krishna Dista. Even though the Vaishnava is Uttam, he is so elevated. He has no ego. I am elevated. Everyone, pay attention to me. He has no abhiman at all and respects everyone, knowing that Krishna is living in all living beings. So, now, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur will present again a number of wonderful verses which embody, which expand upon the sentiments in this third verse of Shikshastakam, which correspond to the state in bhakti called Nishta, steadiness. Nishta means Chitaikagra, Chitaikagra, that the Chitta has become in the state of Ekagrata, one-pointedness. Focus. It is not fully nirvikar, but almost. Almost completely steady. There's a little bit. So, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving a verse from the Mukunda Mala Stotra. Idam shariram shatasandhi jajaram pratyatya vasyam parinama peshalam kimaushadam prichtasi mudda durmate niramayam krishna rasayanam vivo. Idam shariram, it means this body, shatasandhi, has 100 sandhi joints. In other words, what is this body? When the devotee's mind becomes steady, he sees that this body is an alien element. It is foreign. Huh. Just these bones with 100 joints. Jajaram. Jajaram means that it's just slowly going rotten. Yeah? If you have a tomato, you just put it on the side, come back a few days later, it's all wrinkly, and then after that it starts to go green and rotten. Yeah? So the body is like that. Just in a few days, it becomes all wrinkly and it's disgusting. Patatya vasyam. And this body will certainly fall. Parinama peshalam. And then what will happen to it? It will be transformed into the food for worms. Worms can come and eat that dead body. For them it's very delicious. And then after the worms have eaten so much, then the worms will poop. So when you look in the mirror and you think, oh, I am so nice, Just remember, very soon, it will just be a pile of worm poop. Idam Shadi, very great verse. Idam Shadi Ram Shati Sandina Jaram. But Avasyam. Avasyam means definitely. Definitely. There's no avoiding it. Kim Aushadam. Therefore, what medicine will you take? Huh? Everyone is, I want to take this medicine. But you cannot stop it, you cannot save this body. It's doomed. You can see, when people get older, when people are young, they come together, they talk about whatever, music or something like that. But when people get older, they all come together and just talk about their different illnesses and their different medicines. They become obsessed with it. So here is saying, Kim Aushadam, what medicine will you take? Doesn't matter what medicine you take or whatever you do. You will be transformed into the worm poop. So, Prichasi Muda Durmate, oh foolish, wicked mind. You have decorated this condemned, disgusting body with senseless attachment. Why are you attached to it? Krishna has given an example. A bird made a nest in a tree. But then a hunter came with an axe and chop, and he began to cut down the tree. So if the bird will remain there, then the tree will fall down and the bird may be crushed. So the intelligent bird just said, it's time to go, and flies away to his next home. So in the same way, our soul is like a bird living in the nest of the heart. And this body is like a tree. And every day and night that passes is like the cutting of the axe. So why are you attached here? Don't be attached here. The axe is cutting every day. Get ready to fly. So here, Niramayam Krishna, Rasayanam Piba. Oh my dear wicked mind, give up all attachments. And take the Rasayana, a very powerful medicine, tonic, of Krishna Naam. Drink the nectar of Krishna's names. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
And then you become situated in a very beautiful, eternal, transcendental body, which will never grow old, always young and fresh, like Sri Krishna and his associates. Now, in this third chapter, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives a series of verses which are from Stotra Ratna. The Stotra Ratna of Yamuna Acharya. Yes. Oh, it's text 8 to 13, 6 verses. Yamuna Acharya is in the Sri Sampradaya. And Yamunacharya in these verses has expressed the various facets of humility. So these verses are very, very important. Let's hear them and deliberate on them. Take them into your life. And then we'll see where Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is leading us. Nityananda Prabhu, open the marketplace of the Holy Name in Godrundui. Nadia, Nadia Godrume, Nityananda Madan, Patiyate Namate, Jivarakara. Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, I am in the employment of Nityananda Prabhu. I am a sweeper in the marketplace. Because the soul should come to Nityananda Prabhu to receive Shuddha Naam, the pure name. But maybe the path they've come along may have some thorns and stones. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is very merciful. He said, I am the sweeper of the marketplace of the holy name. He is sweeping the path, saying, come, 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 and leading us to the realm of Naam Bhajan. So, let us hear these verses recommended by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and see where he is taking us. Na dharma nishto smi na chapma vedi na bhaktimans twat charanaravinde akinchino nya gati sharanya tat padamulam sharanam prapatye. Oh my Lord, I am not devoted to dharma, religious principles. Nor do I have any knowledge of Atma, the soul. My heart has no bhakti, no devotion at all for your lotus feet. Oh my protector, I am destitute with no shelter, but I am taking shelter of you. I have no other shelter. My Lord, you are the savior of the fallen souls. You came to this world to deliver such wretched persons as me. I am your eternal servant and you are my eternal master. Na ninditam karma tadasti loke sahasraso yanna maya vyadahi soham vipakasa ava sarem kunda krandami samprachagatista vagre. Oh Hari, I confess that there is no sinful or wicked activity that I have not done. Not once, but thousands and thousands of times in many, many lifetimes. And I will suffer for the reactions for those activities. O Mukunda, I see that besides you there is no other shelter. I am constantly crying and praying before you. If you so desire, you can punish me. Because you are the ruler of this destitute person. Nimajjato nanta bhavanavantas chiraya meikula mivasi labdha twaya pilabdham bhagavan idhanim anuttamam patram idam tatayaha. O unlimited Lord Ananta, since time with no beginning, I have been drowning in this endless ocean of material existence. The hope of one day attaining your lotus feet is like the shore of that ocean. Being drowning here, with tears in my eyes, I am praying to you with a choked voice, with great distress. Please appear before me in the form of a guru and deliver me from this world. Bhavantam evanu charam nirantaraha prasanta nishesha manoratantara kadaham aikantiki nitya khinkara prahasa ishami sanata jivitam. Ramananda Rai also taught this verse to Mahaprabhu in relation to Dasya, the mood of a servant. All desires arise from the mind, but those desires are pacified and the mind becomes peaceful only by continuous, uninterrupted devotional service to you. When will I be accepted? Kadaham aikantiki nitya kinkara, as your nitya kinkara. Your kinkara means servant, but it means kim karomi. What can I do for you? So when will I be accepted as your servant? Prahasya isyami sanata jivitam. And I will feel great jubilation to have such a great master. A servant, a real servant, is always blissful. Why? Because they think, my master is so wonderful. Whatever happens to me, whatever is going on, this is not relevant. But I am fortunate because my Lord is so wonderful. Aparada sahasra bhajanam patitam bhima bhavanava uttare agatim sharanagatam hare kripya kevalam atma satkuru. Oh Hari!
Oh Hari!
That means everyone is absorbed. Yes. Aparada sahasra bhajanam. Oh Hari, I am very offensive. I am guilty of thousands and thousands of offenses, and I am fit to be punished. I am drowning in this fearsome ocean of material existence. I am completely lost. Please make me your own Atma Satguru. Atma Satguru. That means Atma Sat means that I am yours. I am not independent from you. I am completely dependent on you. May my heart be one with your heart. Atma Sat. You have promised to deliver anyone who takes shelter of you. Therefore, please deliver me. Tasman matsharnam gostam mannatam matparigraham gopaye swatma yogina soyam te brata'aita soyam me brata'aita. Krishna has made a vow, if anyone will take shelter of me, I must protect them. So here Jumonachari is reminding the Lord, remember that vow? So I have come to take shelter of you. Please afford me your protection. Then, na mrisha paramartam eva me shrinu vigyapanam ekamagrata yadi me na dayas yase tato dayanias tavat nata durlabaha. Oh Hari, I am submitting at your lotus feet this petition in which there is not the slightest untruth. You may or may not be merciful to me. But my prayer is this. If you are not merciful to me, it will be impossible to find another candidate suitable for mercy. You see, if someone does something, they are deserving of some reciprocation. But someone does nothing and they have no qualities, they're not deserving of anything. So when you give to someone something they deserve, that's called justice. But when something is given which was not deserved, that is mercy. So when we approach the Lord, we don't approach the Lord, oh Krishna, I've done so much for you. What about helping me out? That means don't make your application in the Department of Justice. File your application in the Department of Mercy. So, if the Lord is truly doyamoy, full of mercy, and gives grace to undeserving person, then, if you will not give grace to me, then where will you find another candidate? Because I am the most undeserving person. You cannot find another candidate as useless as me. So, my Lord, if you don't Make me the object of your merciful sidelong glance. Everyone comes every day to have darshan, see Thakurji. But one day you will see Thakurji looking at you. Kripa will come. We pray for that every day. Shubha drishti karo prabhu jagatero prati jago karitaye mara sumangala rati. Oh my Lord, glance upon me with your auspicious merciful glance, and by that glance awaken rati. Awaken spontaneous love within my heart. So Jamunacharya is saying that if you don't give mercy to me, then you will not be able to find another candidate who is more useless, who is truly and can be an object of your mercy. And if you don't glance at me with your beautiful sidelong glance, then your name of Patipavan, who purifies the fallen, your name of Dina Bandhu, the friend of the distressed, oh, it will be disgraced. No one will be able to call you that anymore because you have not lived up to your name. So then, Yamunacharya said, Amaryada chudastalamati asuya prasavabhu kritagno duramanis paraparobasho rakshana para. I am disrespectful. I am very petty, vile. My mind is fickle. Asuya, I am full of envy. I am ungrateful. I am dependent on others. I am cruel and sinful. In this condition, how can I cross this ocean of material existence? How will I ever attain the service of your lotus feet? This is Tanada Pisuniji. When we hear this, then we can see whether we are Vaishnava or not. Vaishnava hite chilomoda sad, Tanada Pisuniji chain slokuka. Parigaluvad, one poet, he said, I heard that Vaishnavas are very glorious. So I decided I will also become a Vaishnava. But when I set off to become a Vaishnava, I came up against a very difficult obstacle. What was that? Was this verse, Trinada Pisunichena. Then I thought, oh, how can I ever be a Vaishnava? Tava dasya sukhaika sanginam, verse 15. Bhavanesh astapi kita janmame itara vasateshu masma bhut api janma chatur mukatmana. O Bhagavan, if I take birth again due to my past activities, or by your desire, then please let me take birth in the home of a devotee. Even if that birth is in the body of an insect, let it be in the house of a devotee. I have no desire to take birth in a household where there's no bhakti to you, even if it is the house of Lord Brahma, the greatest palace in the highest planet in the universe. I don't want to be there if there's no devotion there. This is my prayer to you. So taking inspiration from these prayers of Yamunacharya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakura has manifested so many kirtans. Kita janma hau jada tuadas ba वाहि मोक ब्रह्म जन्मे नहि आज. ओ माय लॉर्ड, इफ आई हैव टू टेक बर्थ अगेन इवन एज एन इंसेक्ट, then let it be in the house of your devotee. I don't want to take birth even as Lord Brahma if it means that I will be averse to you. Manusya hoto vahi rasakana charo braja gokula gaun nandaki gwan jo pasha hoto kahan basa mero charo nitya nandaki tenu charavi. जो पश हो तो बही गिरी को जो दारियो का छत्र पुरंदर कार जो कग हो तो बसेर करो मिली कालिंद कूल के दंब की धारण. द ग्रेट वैष्णव पोएट रसखान, ही इज ऑल्सो प्रेड इन दिस वे. मनुष्य हो तो बही रसखान, इफ आई टेक बर्थ दैट मीन्स नाउ आई एम अबाउट टू डाई. Now my death is near. If I have to take birth again as a human being, may I be born in Nandagaon. But if I cannot be in human form, jo pasha ho to kahan basa mero, if I have to take birth as an animal, then let me take birth as a cow. In the herd of Krishna. In the herd of Nanda. Actually, it's Nanda Maharaj's cows. Krishna's nothing. In the herd of Nanda Maharaj. But if I'm not qualified even to be an animal, if I have to be a stone, jo pash olto kahan basam mero, let me take birth as a stone at Giriraj Govardhan. Or if I have to take birth as a bird, let me be a bird perched on the branch of a kadamba tree on the bank of Japan. But somehow, let me always be in your dham. May I always have the association of your devotees. Once one student who was writing a PhD about different gurus, he was visiting different gurus and interviewing them. He came to Gurudev and he asked him the question, oh, when you go to Goloka Vrindavan, then who will be the next acharya after you? And when Gurudev heard it, he just, the first sentence, when you go to Goloka Vrindavan, he just heard that and he became stunned. And he didn't answer the second part of the question, just the first part. He said, when I leave, I will not go to Goloka Vrindavan. But if I am fortunate, perhaps I can be a blade of grass on the bank of Jamuna in this Vrindavan. So when the Vaishnavas are doing Vrindavan Parikrama, I can get their foot dust. Then I will be very fortunate. Bhuta maya apanaki manitranata. The highest Vaishnavas think that they are the lowest. So then Yamunacharya is saying, 16. Vapura disu yopiko piva gunato sani yata tata vidha tadayam tava padapad mayur ahamadvaya maya samarpitaha. O Bhagavan, in this material existence, there are bodily distinctions between male and female. And according to the three modes of material nature, sattva, rajas and tamas, there are the divisions of occupations like brahmanas, kshatriyas, vaishyas and sudras. And the four ashrams, brahmacharis, grihastha, vanaprastha and sannyas. In this way, humanity has unlimited varieties. O Praneshwara, Lord of my life, let me take birth in any of these bodies, in any condition. It does not matter to me. I don't care what condition I take birth in. Why? Because I am completely surrendered to you and nothing is mine. Everything is yours. As long as there is a slight trace of identification and attachment for the body, it's not possible to do bhajan. Remember? We discussed in the beginning. It's archan. But bhajan takes place where there's no sense of bodily identification. Then, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 17, he is presenting a verse from Krishna Kanamrita of Bilva Mangal Thakur. Nibada modanjali esha yache niranda dainunati mukta kantam dayanidi deva bhavatkataksham dakshinyale shena sakrinni sincha. O Dev! That means, Dev means God, but really Dev means Kridashil, who's playful, who performs beautiful leelas like the Rasa Leela. O Dev! O Dayanidhi! O ocean of mercy! With folded hands, raised upon my head, I am bowing down and humbly, I am offering this prayer to you. Please, please, just once, shower me with your merciful glance. Then he is giving another verse from Krishna Kanamrita. Mai prasadam madurayaka taksha bangsi ninad anu charavidehi twayi prasane kimiha pararnas twaya prasane kimiha paranaha. O Krishna, kindly bestow your mercy upon me through your sidelong glance, which is accompanied with the sound of your flute. When you are pleased with me, then there's no harm if other people are not pleased with me. And if you are displeased with me, if you are displeased with me, Krishna, then what is the use if others are pleased? So, just consider this. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he has skill in bhajan. This is called bhajan chaturya. Many persons chant the holy name for a long time, but they're not making so much progress because they don't have bhajan chaturya, expertise in bhajan. But Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is empowered, Gaura Shakti Swarupaya, empowered by Mahaprabhu, Gadada Pandit himself, to show Rupanuga Varayate, the path of Rupanuga Bhajan. So, though these last two verses are from Krishna Kanamrita, written by Srila Bilva Mangal Thakur, you should know that each of the verses, the prayers of Krishna Kanamrita, have three levels of meaning. One level of meaning is that Srila Bilva Mangal Thakur is going to Vrindavan with his disciples and he's telling them very beautiful prayers to Krishna, his own prayers to see Krishna in his sadhaka form. Another meaning is that these verses are actually spoken by Srimati Radharani. And another meaning is that these are verses spoken by some dasi of Radhika, praying to Krishna to come because she cannot tolerate Radharani's separation from Krishna. So there are three levels of meaning in these verses. So, after presenting a sweet or very touching, very heartbreaking verses, expressions of humility. Now Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, in that mood of humility, the devotee will pray, Nibada Modanjali Esha Yache. O Dev, O playful Krishna, who plays in the rasa dance, I take my hands upon my head and bow down and beg you, please, glance at me once again. Whose words are they? Radhika's words. So in the commentaries on this verse, Srila Krishna Skaraj in his Saranga Ranga Datika said that Radhika is speaking this verse in the mood of the last verse of Brahmargit. When the bumblebee was flying around her feet, Krishna had gone to Mathura and Radhika was sitting in that place which is now known as Udhavkeri, near Nandaga. And a bumblebee was flying by her lotus feet, attracted by the fragrance, thinking, oh, this is a real lotus. And she said, Madhupakitava bandho, maspashangrim sabadna, kuchavilalita mala, kunkamasmasuvina. Bhatu Madhupatistan Maninam Prasada Yarusada Sibidangam Yasidutastamitrik. Oh, Madhupa. Madhupa means who drinks madhu. Madhu can mean honey but also means wine. So Madhupa is a bumblebee and Madhupa is also an alcoholic. So in Vedic culture, taking intoxication is more degrading, more sinful than eating meat. So one should never associate with a person who takes intoxication. So I said, Madhupa, intoxicated person, Kitava Bandho, friend of a cheetah, Mas Prasha, don't touch my feet. Get out from here. Go back to Mathura. Be with your friend Krishna. He needs your help there. And Radhika, she criticized that bumblebee with so many strong words. I don't want to hear anything about Krishna. Yadanu charita lila kana piyu savi prut sakritadavar viduta dvandva dharma vinasta sapati griha kitumbam dina mutsvitya dina bhavaya vahanga bhikshu charyam charanti. I don't want to listen to anything about Krishna. Indeed, if I could find that first person who first put the description of Krishna in my ear, the first drop of Krishna Katha that went in my ear, if I could find that person, then I would give them such a punishment that they will never be cruel to anyone ever again. It's so cruel. Because if one drop of Krishna Katha will enter into someone's ear, then dvandva dharma vinasta, their dedication to the dualities of worldly life is completely destroyed. Sapati kriya kutumbam. At once that person just gets up and leaves their family, leaves everything. On the one side their family are crying, oh, where did he go, where did he go? And on the other hand that person is crying, where is Krishna? I cannot find Krishna. Everyone is crying. So Krishna is Madhusudan. Madhu means happiness and Sudha means one who cuts. Krishna is Madhusudan. Be careful of Madhusudan. If you have any connection with Krishna, you will, all your happiness will be destroyed. You will suffer, you will suffer, you will suffer forever. So Radhika said, Bhava Yavihanga Bhikshucharyam Charanti. If a person will just be touched by one drop of Harikatha, they become homeless. They live in the forest. Underneath the tree. Like a bird. They survive by begging. Somehow or other. Bhikshucharyam, they become beggars. Like homeless birds staying under a tree, another tree, another tree. So Radhika was criticizing the bumblebee. I don't want to hear anything about Krishna. Then the bumblebee flew somewhere and then she thought, oh no, went back to Mathura and he must have told Krishna all the terrible things I said. Then the next moment, it was probably another bumblebee. Perhaps not even the same bumblebee. We don't know. Jiva Goswami said, we don't know. But she thought that that same bumblebee had returned from Mathura after telling Krishna everything. But Krishna is so kind that he didn't take offense, and now he sent the messenger back to try again. So this time when Radhika saw the bumblebee, instead of Mas Prashangrim Sapatnya, don't touch my feet, she was Priya Sakap Punaga. Oh, she was so overwhelmed with emotion. Oh, Priya Saka, my dear friend Bumblebee, Punaga, you came back. Please, take a seat. How can I serve you? And she welcomed the bumblebee. Then she said, Uddhav is at some distance and looking and watching Radhika speaking with the bumblebee. He's never seen such love before. He could not imagine such love. Radhika is Mahabhav Swarup, who is made of love. Radhika said, Abhibata Madhupurya Arya Putra Dunaste Smarati Sopit Kehan Somya Pandung Stagopan Kachitabhi Sakatana Kinkarinam Grinite Bujamaguru Sugandam Morja Jastat Kadanu Abhibata Madhupurya Arya Putra Dunaste Adhun, now Krishna is in Madhupuri. What does that mean? Because when Krishna went to Mathura, after a short time, he left Mathura and went to Ujjain, to the ashram of Sandipani Muni, to Gurukul, and he studied 64 arts there, and he came back. When he came back, that's when he sent Uddhava. So she said, Abhibata Madhupuryam, Aryaputra. Now Aryaputra is now back in Madhupuri. Aryaputra. This is very polite, you see. Because a wife never says the name of a husband. She'll say, oh, the son of this person. And especially the father-in-law is very noble. So the husband is Aryaputra, son of a nobleman. So this is the very, very polite way, very humble way in which a wife may address her husband. So Radhika is, of course, not married to Krishna. But she feels very humble. And she's speaking politely. Now Aryaputra has come back to Mathura. Smarati Sapitrigehan. She is very eager to see him, to meet him, to serve him. But it's very difficult to express. So she said, Smarti Sapitrigeha. She asked, does Krishna remember his parents' house? Now he's in the big city, the metropolis, living in a palace. Now he became royalty in the Yadu dynasty. Does he remember the dairy farm that he came from, Gosht, Braja? Surely, he must remember his mother and father, Smarti Sapitrigeha, because blood is thicker than water. He is their own flesh. So he must remember his parents' house. Somya Bandung Stagopya. And does he remember his friends? Like Subal, Sridhar, with whom he used to play in the forest. Then she came to the point. Kochitapi Sakatana. Does he sometimes say anything about us? The gopis? Kinkarinam Grinite, his kinkaris, his maidservants, whom he accepted, because they went to Rasalila. At first he told them to go home, but then when they started crying, he laughed and then accepted them. And especially when Rasalila began, then Krishna took Radhika alone. So here, hidden in this, Kinkari, he accepted us. Means, I remember that day, leaving everybody else, he just took me alone. Kinkari Namgrinite. Oh, Bamubi, does he sometimes talk about us? That means, does he sometimes speak about us in a positive way? Does he sit with the young princesses of Mathura and tell them, oh, this garland you have made is not so good. You are not so artistic like my gopis of Vrindavan. They make wonderful garlands. They know really how to please me. Does he say this? Or does he even speak about us in a negative way? Oh, my dear princess of Mathura, you are so educated and sophisticated, not like those rustic village girls I grew up with. Does he sometimes speak in the morning? He wakes up and he gets dressed in front of his mirror. And he looks in the mirror and he sees that he's put on a shirt that we have sewn and gave to him as a gift, and he took it with him to Mathura. And when Sri Krishna puts on that shirt we have made for him, he looks and sees his reflection and becomes bewildered in separation and thinks his reflection is someone else wearing a shirt made by his beloved, and said, you too? You also went very far away from your beloved and forgot about them. Bujma Guru Sugandha murdered us Tatkadalu. As Radhika was speaking in his way to the Bumblebee, then, these verses come now. Nibada Mohanjali, oh Krishna, taking my hands on my head and bowing down, I am begging you, please, will you glance at me one more time and play your flute? The implication is she's remembering that moment in the Rasalila where Krishna took his flute and moved his eyebrows and indicated, psst, let's go there. And by his glance, made Radhika the most fortunate of all the gopis and took her away to their very beautiful Nikunja Lila. Will such fortune ever come to me again? Then Radhika saw a spurti that Krishna was coming. She said, Bujama Guru Sukanda Murtidas Tatkadanu. Oh, will Krishna, with his hand fragrant like agur, you know, that's oud. His hand fragrant with agur. Will he come to me and place his hand on my head? That means to give a blessing. That means, oh my Pran Priyata, my most beloved, I went here and there. I met so many very beautiful young ladies from earth, from heaven, Nagas, from everywhere in the universe. But nowhere did I see anyone so sweet and loving as you. So now I am back and I'll never leave you again. And as Radharani was saying this, will Krishna come and bless me in this way? Then she had the spurti of Krishna appearing and she fainted. She had so many intense sattvic bhavs, even her sakis could not recognize her. All began to cry. Uddhava was crying. and they all fainted. So Srila Gurudev in his commentary explains that if a person giving up attachment to this body chants continuously and cries at the feet of the holy name these prayers of Yamunacharya, his stotra, and then in that humble mood remembers the separation of Radhika, these verses, then in his heart, which has now become steady and absorbed, Ruchi will appear. Experience of the sweetness of Vrindavan will appear, and then we'll come to chapter 4. So please come tomorrow morning and we'll be in chapter 4.